This is our job for today. We've got to build a staircase coming up the side of the building up here. We've got 12 steps, then it's all flat. And just up the end here, we've got 5 steps. Nice easy one. I'm going to show you a different way to do it than what I did last time. So what we're going to do first, mark one side. We have worked out a top height and a bottom height. From there, we just divide it by the ideal size, which is 172 mil. Then we just figure out a size of riser that's close to that as possible. We also don't have a set going, so we figure out what going to go with. We're going to aim for around 300. All these steps are going to have fall on them so that any water will run down the staircase and not pool on the stairs. I like to mark both sides, it's just more accurate. We're gonna build this one out of planks. It's exposed aggregate, so our finish doesn't need to be good. We just need them to be straight and strong. All right, first thing we're gonna do is figure out the difference in height here so that we can divide it up and find out our riser height. We're coming off the garage. I've come up 20 mil, so we have some fall down to the garage, because there's drains there. That is the top of our top rise. That is bottom of our bottom rise. 1910. So we're going to divide that by 172. 172 is our ideal riser size. Yep, it's 11.1. So now it's close to 11, so I'm going to divide 1910 by 11. 173.6, that's the rise I'm going to go with. So I'm going to write that down. Now we want to find out our going. So if we've got 11 risers, we're going to have 10 goings. It's always one less. So I'm going to go 300. So I'll write that down. 3 meters is going to be my overall run. So I'm going to mark that. So I've got my top point marked. Now this is the bottom of our bottom rise. So we're going to come up one rise, 173. And then we want to ping a line. Now what I like to do, I've got my line pinged. I like to measure the overall, divide it up by the 10 goings, and then that gives me all my top riser points. Now we can also do that mathematically. So I've got an app. So we just enter in the details. And then to measure the divisions, we can just use our tape, but I like to use this tool. It's called a Tremel. Now it's time to square this first step up. So I'm gonna use this wall. So I've got 200 mil here. I've got 200 mil here. So now we just count 200 mil here. 200, that's square. Now I've got a cool little trick for carrying a height across from one wall to the other. You just hold your laser against the wall until your green line lines up on the other side where you want it to. Boom. Thank you. concrete nails. So with very little effort, we've got our first six steps in. And we're just using our stringers on the wall, plates on the risers, little packers to fill the gap, and plank risers. With the width of these, I'm gonna have to put a brace down the center. Here, I'm gonna show you how to brace up these risers because they're too wide and they're gonna bow when the concrete hits it. So we're gonna tech screw every one, opposing sides each riser. This step needs to move forward about 3 mil. So I use a clamp. This brace helps strengthen the risers vertically, so people standing on this, it won't sag. We've spaced it all out, so we got exactly 300 on every step, but nothing stopping it kicking until I put these on. So we're all complete, that's another job down. Thanks for watching my video.